Hello, my name is Janelle Roberts, and my mentor is Dr. Jen Manak. My summer research project is about exploring the American Revolution from multiple perspectives through critical literacy discussions in a fifth grade classroom. The Massachusetts frameworks requires fifth grade teachers to teach the American Revolution. Oftentimes, teachers will use a textbook that only has one perspective. That perspective is usually a white, male perspective. However, integrating children's literature into social studies instruction promotes students to actively engage and enriches the social studies curriculum by making the content more understandable and more memorable. It also provides students with meaningful experiences that they cannot similarly receive from a textbook. Teachers can integrate children's literature by using techniques such as read alouds, independent reading, literature circles, and text sets. This study focuses on the use of text sets, which supplements the use of the social studies textbook. Text sets are composed of several books on a similar topic that represent a range of reading levels and genres. Comprehensive text sets include approximately 20 to 25 books on a topic. Here is an example of a text set that we use to explore African Americans in the Revolutionary America. The texts within each of the text sets received recognition or were awarded for as quality fiction or nonfiction by nationally recognized groups such as the American Library Association, International Reading Association, and the National Council of Social Studies. Part of my study has the students critically reading the text sets to view multiple perspectives of the American Revolution. Critical literacy views readers as active participants in the reading process and invites them to move beyond passively accepting the text message to question, examine, or dispute the power relations that exist between readers and authors. Some questions that students may ask are, whose voice is missing? Whose voice is represented? Or, why do you think the author wrote this book from this perspective? Critical literacy also focuses on the issues of power and promotes reflection, transformation, and action. The teacher in our research classroom encouraged students to have critical literacy discussions in small groups as well as contributing in class discussions. Ultimately, critical literacy focuses on the power relationship between author and reader. My study focuses on how reading quality literature on the American Revolution from critical stance influences fifth grade students' understanding of this historical time period from multiple perspectives. The research site that we studied at was a multicultural suburban elementary school in southeastern Massachusetts, and we were in a fifth grade classroom with 19 students and one teacher. We gave the students a pre-assessment before starting the unit on the American Revolution to assess their knowledge about what they already knew. The pre-assessment consisted of three questions. What was the American Revolution? Why did the American Revolution occur? And who participated in the American Revolution? And the students placed an X beside the group or groups of people they believed participated in the American Revolution. Men, women, young people, African Americans, Native Americans, British loyalists, and patriots. From the results of the pretest, we were able to see that most students only believed that men were involved and were either a loyalist or a patriot. Following the pre-assessment, the students began the unit by learning about the events leading up to the American Revolution. The students used an educational website called BrainPop, as well as their textbook, Our Nation. After the students learned about the events prior to the American Revolution, the students finished by taking the pretest again to assess their knowledge learned from these two sources. After each lesson, the teacher would engage the students in a critical literacy discussion. They would talk about the text that they were reading and ask questions. The teacher broke down the quality children's literature into six groups, each portraying a different perspective. Women, patriots, young people, African Americans, British loyalists, and Native Americans. The students were then broken up into groups of four or five to study each perspective. The students would have small group discussions about the text at hand while being guided by a teacher-crafted worksheet. After the students read about all of their perspectives, the students chose their own groups to further their understanding about a perspective that they found interesting. After a little digging, the students presented what they had learned to the class. The students made visually friendly posters to help display their newfound knowledge. All the students became classroom experts on their perspective. After they presented, they took the pretest again. The results showed that the students' knowledge about who was in the American Revolution had developed. By the end, the students understood that women, young people, African Americans, and Native Americans were all involved. As you can see, the red is the results from the pretest that they took on May 13th. The yellow is after they read their textbooks in Brain Pop on May 20th. And the post-test took place after reading all the children's literature as well as presenting to the class on June 25th. After my observations, I transcribed the audio recordings and coded them. Through the coding process, these three themes emerged from my data during my analysis. The first theme was evaluating text from multiple perspectives. The students were able to notice biases as well as look at multiple forms of text and evaluate which each one was able to provide for them as critical readers. They were also able to evolve an understanding over the course of the unit, so their perspective changed about the American Revolution and developed. Lastly, the students were able to develop a whole picture through multiple perspectives. They were able to see that the American Revolution had multiple perspectives, as well as information that they had not known prior. Ultimately, the students were able to relate to this historical event and put it into context. During a classroom discussion, the teacher and the students evaluated the text from multiple perspectives. During a classroom discussion, the teacher asked, "Tell me about it, our textbook. How did we feel about our textbook as a source?" And a student responded, "I don't want to use it anymore." Why? Because it's like always coming from the colonist side or perspective. It doesn't really talk about how the British felt or how they didn't like it. So it was pretty biased. But did you learn a lot from the colonist's point of view? Yes. The students were able to recognize that the textbook doesn't show all perspectives. They also decided as a class that the textbook only showed the colonist's point of view. Another example of the students evaluating a text was when a few students were working together. During the partner discussion, one student said, "We are focusing on chapter 3, and that is the Warriors for the Republic." So I asked, "So who do you think chapter 3 is about?" A different student responded, "The Native Americans." A third student said, "Well, it says Indians in here." "Well, Mrs. C and I were talking earlier, and we were listing all of them, and I think Allison said Native Americans, and she said yes." The students read what the text said and then debated what it meant. They learned that later both words mean the same group of people. One student's perspective changed after hearing the British perspective. During an interview, the student responded, "I am on the British side now because I don't think that the colonists should have overreacted that much, like dumping all their tea into the ocean. I also thought it was a bad thing because they are basically polluting the water. I also thought that boycotting was kind of bad and could have ruined the government right at that moment and lost thousands and thousands of dollars. And I said in my writing that the British had an empire scattered across the whole world, so they needed to get money and supplies to keep those people around the world safe and get them protection." If this student hadn't read the children's literature, he would have not been able to develop his own opinion about the American Revolution. Within a small group discussion, the teacher and the student discussed an important female figure in the American Revolution, Deborah Sampson. The teacher suggested, "Because if you think it's interesting that Molly Pitcher fired a gun, then you will be very surprised at what Deborah Sampson did. Go over and ask Rebecca about Deborah Sampson." So she came back and told her group. "So she, I think she either cut her hair or put it into her helmet, and she disguised herself as a boy." "Why did she have to disguise herself as a boy?" "Because she was going into the war, so they wouldn't know, and they didn't let women in war." "Okay, so now I want you to think. Put yourself in her perspective. Now imagine that you're in the Revolutionary War, and she obviously is very passionate about it, but they said, 'Oh, you're a girl, you can't be in it.' How are you gonna feel?" "Mad." "Yeah, because you know what? I can do this." "Absolutely. She pretended that she was a boy so she could get out there and fight. I thought you might find her interesting." The student was able to explore a woman's perspective as well as connective feelings in order to develop a full understanding of how this woman may have felt during the Revolutionary War. After hearing the students present their final projects, they were able to understand the American Revolution as a whole. During the final project discussion, the teacher asked, "So overall, it was a pleasant experience for the African Americans during the Revolutionary War?" And one student responded, No, it wasn't pleasant because they were tricked, fooled, and used in the war just to try and win the war. And they didn't even win, so they had to stay with the British instead of going back to their families. Students were able to see multiple perspectives outside of their initial thinking of the male British loyalists and male patriots. My future plans for this project is to further my research with my honors thesis that will be completed in May 2014, and I would like to apply to present at the National Conference on Undergraduate Research in April 2014 at Lexington, Kentucky. And I will also be implementing critical literacy discussions in my future classroom. I would like to thank my mentor, Dr. Jen Manak, who has guided me throughout this whole process, as well as Mrs. C, who is our fifth grade teacher that allowed us into our classroom. And I would also like to thank the Adrian Zinsley Summer Research Program for funding my research this summer. Thank you.